शुद्धाय दिगंबराय तस्मै नकाराय नमः शिवाय।
नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। I welcome you all for this second day of the Conquering Life program. I think we are almost in 60 countries now. First thing you want to do today, to clear all your doubts and help you to internalize and experience these three truths I shared yesterday. See, I am not interested in giving you more and more thought current, but I am only interested in whatever these three thought current sacred truths I shared, making it as your experience. Making it as your experience. Instead of hearing more and more and more thought currents, if you experience at least these few sacred secrets and go back, I'll be really happy. Listen. Focus on the three sacred truths I revealed yesterday. One. Listen. One. How life occurs to you. Second. Approach why with the zeal of solving it, not to blame. Third, completion, reliving, and will to manifest new reality is immediate most practical solution. Maybe I will welcome the new participants and encourage the new participants to come and have your doubts cleared more than the IA grads trying to get my attention. I may request all the new participants, if you are first time here, please come. Come to the mic. I may welcome all the first timers, new participants. You may need my attention more to make these truths into reality. Go ahead, go ahead.
Nithyanandam, welcome. Completion process, when you tell me to relieve, we forgot many of the incidents since.
No, whatever you remember, That only is still sitting inside you as a blockage. If you forgot something good, it is no more a blockage in you. Understand? Celebrate that you forgot. People come and tell me worries are haunting me. When I tell, okay, relieve them, Swamiji, I forgot, then come on. Feel blessed for what you forgot. What you remember, if you relieve, that's enough.
Again, for manifesting them into reality, whatever you wish to do, what kind of the visualization that we have to brought into?
See, what you want, command it with your will. Please understand one thing. All of you listen. Your will is the umbilical cord connection between your individual soul and the cosmos. If you shake your individual soul with your will, cosmos has to shiver, because it is connected through the spiritual umbilical cord, your will. I don't know how many of you read in Puranas, a yogi sits under the tree and starts meditating, creating certain will to get that boon, and Indraloka burns, Devaloka shakes, and Indra has to run, Brahma has to run to attend. It is true. If you sit here and create a will, if you can shake your individual soul, your individuality with your will, naturally you will make the cosmos shake, move. Visualize very as clearly as you can what you want as your life, how you want your life to be manifested, and will it. Understand, when you will, multiple energies in your biomemory, in your muscle memory, in your system gets integrated to that will. Actually, you have multiple energies inside you. Unfortunately, all of them are in their own direction. Even complete you do not know what you want. Because morning you told yourself you want this. By noon you already changed. By night it is different. By the time your first order reaches from head to toe, there is a second order. By the time that reaches your from your head to toe, your desires have changed. Even you as whole do not know what you want. Understand?
Individual will is obstacled by nervousness and fear mostly. How can we
again
conquer?
That is again your disturbed ideas about you. You can clearly tell yourself even that to be healed by your own will. Understand? Your will. Actually, this which you are saying, nervousness and all that, is nothing but your decision not to will. So your will can heal it, and I will support it.
Nityanandam ji, Nityanandam.
The next question we have from Milpitas, California Center. Raj is asking, what is will? Just executing your intention?
Please understand, here, when I am using the word will, I am not even going to the step of executing. I am only asking you, will it? Means declare it. What will happen usually when you declare, you know, your own internal energies get integrated. That's the actual first step supposed to happen in you. Then the execution will happen not as you usually imagine. You struggle, make 10 project plan, scratch 9, sometimes 9.5, and then rebuild, and in this confusion get tired, bored and sick, curse everyone around you and you. Don't even bring the word executing, because there is too much of incompletion with that word executing within you. Please understand, how many of you, the moment you think you need to execute something, there is so much of incompletion? I am telling you. Incompletion with executing is incompletion with life. I know it is there. That is why I am saying, don't even bring the word executing. Will is powerful enough. Will is powerful enough to integrate. Then it is capable enough to manifest. Maybe a little bit of your cooperation is required, but you may not need to do this whole executing exercise. Most of the time your execution exercise is almost like fighting with yourself. Next.
The next question we have is from Noosa, Australia. Ian Anderson is asking the question. Thank you, Swamiji, for answering my question. Can I ask why your image varies from being a male personal when you are speaking to us and then a female personal when you are not speaking to us? From Noosa, Australia.
Nusa, understand, an enlightened being cannot be constrained into, first of all, one body. Forget about constraining me into one gender. In Vedic tradition, we call enlightened beings as transcendental gender, not transgender. Transcendental gender. Neither male nor female or gay or lesbian or transgender. It's a separate kind of a body. We call it Divya Sarira, which reflects the way you want to see, you will go on be seeing it. The way you want to perceive, you will be perceiving it. The way you want to enjoy, you will be enjoying it. So it is, even in language, words, Sanskrit gives exemption from all the grammar rules, everything, to enlightened beings. The Sanskrit grammarian, he says, enlightened beings are expressing, trying to express something which can never be expressed through words. So they are exempted from all grammar rules, everything. It is called Arsha Prayoga. Whenever a rishi uses the language for his own convenience, the way he wants and the way he interprets, it is accepted as a trend and grammar rule. And it is called Arsha Prayoga. He is not bound by the linguistic rules, grammar rules. Same way, an enlightened being cannot be constrained even to one body with so much of difficulty when he is trying to express through one body, you can never be able to constrain him to one gender. Whether psychology or physiology or the whole system, the body I carry, nothing can be framed into one gender. Actually, the enlightenment itself is a physiological, psychological mutation. So that is why, if you are a keen observer, means if you are a living, observing, witnessing personality, then you can understand the form I am carrying is beyond the genders. Nusa, I think you are the Nusa Australia person, Ian Anderson. I think your ability to absorb or observe is too much. That's all I can say. And you are right.
The next question we have is from Enlightened Brilliant Studio, Oregon. The question is asked by a participant named Ty. He's asking an interesting question. Does God help the people who help themselves first, or the person who's lazy and who keeps taking help from others?
Please understand, the person who is lazy will not even be able to take help from others. There are only two kinds of people. Life negative, who neither help themselves nor take help from others. Another one, life positive, who helps themselves and take help from others. Helping yourself and taking help from others is one and the same. If you will help yourself, you will take help from others. And you will help others. So the classification you are making, lazy and helping themselves, in that you are making one small mistake. You think lazy persons take help from others. No. Understand the two classification, life positive, life negative. If you are helping yourself, God will be helping you. If you are taking help from others again, God will be helping you through others. A person who helps themselves will always be taking help from others and helping others. Lazy fellows, neither they will help themselves nor they will take help from others, or they will help others. So understand, God helps the people who help themselves. After all, He is sitting in yourself. Next.
The next question we will take from a participant from Bengaluru, Adinam. Please go ahead.
Pranams, respected Swamiji. Excuse me. I apologize if I hurt you at any time. It is not my intention to scold you or hurt you. Because I love Sach Sai Baba. He says, help ever, hurt never. When this is the case, this simple problem cannot be achieved by me or by many of the citizens. So, how to help and hurt never? This is more important, hurting never. I came here not on my own intention, but this is my second visit. So, some forces has dragged me here. I salute to those powers, and I immediately say, and I apologize for what I have done, and I know that divinity is also in me, which is similar to your your divinity. But the manifestation is not taking place. And I want Sonayas Maranam and Anayas Jivanam, which is everybody's wish. And I also wish the same thing. But at the same time, the Ramana Maharshi, he is silently teaching. And similarly, Swami Vivekananda says what you say yesterday, awake, arise, and till the goal is reached, stop not. That is the same thing what I heard from you. So, I request you to bless me to have the similar highest values in my life. And the God, I know the God is protecting me from all the sides and giving me what I required. And at the same time, for the world also I need that I am successful, not a failure candidate. But now, I am a failure candidate in my life. So, the success is to be generated not only from me, but from cosmetic energy. That I request you and bless me. Thank
my
you.
My blessings. Yes.
The next question we have is from Vancouver Center, Dhruvraj. Dhruvraj is asking, to conquer, do you need to know your purpose? If you do not know your purpose, how do you conquer and find out? Vancouver,
Dhruvraj, first thing you understand, do not expect your past to tell your purpose. Decide to create for yourself. We always think our past should tell our purpose. No. Create your purpose based on the input and intelligence from your past. Whatever you think as the best, create the purpose. Understand? Past is dead. If you are waiting for inspiration from it, you will never get. From dead things, you get only smell, not inspiration. Now, most of the time, you are sitting and waiting from your dead past, the inspiration will come out like an angel and possess you and drive you. No! That's never going to happen. People come and tell me, Swamiji, whatever repeatedly I think, should I take that as a purpose of me? No. Whatever actually your incompletion, you will be repeatedly thinking about that. Do enough of completion. From that completion space, you will, you create your purpose. Do not wait for the purpose to come from inside you as accident. Dhruvraj, what you think as the best thing for your life, create the purpose. Creating the purpose will make you conquer life. Don't wait for some accidental or words, intuition coming from inside and all that. No. And Dhruvraj, I see you as potential being who can really conquer the life, who can really manifest what you want. So do not wait for your past to guide you. Your past is mostly incompletion. So if you are waiting for your intuition from the past, it will be mostly incompletion. So decide to create as you want. That will only conquer your life.
The next question we have is from Sydney Center. Swamiji, if most things in my life are going really well, except for allowing constant stream of money to flow to me, Can I focus on the bliss and joy which all the other areas brought to me and use this energy to visualize and feel the constant flow of money coming in? Nityanandam, thank you.
First thing, Lee Kam Liam. This whole question is about the wealth dimension of you. I'll give you one important truth. Activism is wealth. Understand? In any field, you are active, you can convert that into wealth. You can make that as a wealth flow in your life. Actually, this one truth itself need to be expanded as a program. Maybe the next program, Secrets of Attracting Wealth, is specially for you. To answer this question, I invite you, please come and experience how the activism can be converted into wealth. How activism can be a flow of wealth in your life. I invite you to come and enjoy The Secrets of Attracting Wealth. That will really make experiential answer for this question.
The next question we'll take from Bengaluru Adinam. Please go ahead.
Pranam Swamiji. I'm really grateful to Almighty for having me, brought me here. My question is based on yesterday's deliberation. I just be very specific in my question. How to ensure that I'm correct in my analysis of the problem, identifying appropriate reasons.
And please judge, understand.
Could you?
How much ever you analyze in the initial level, you will be analyzing only to a certain limit. But with more and more completion, your analysis will become more precise. When your analysis is complete, the problem will not be there. Yesterday I was telling, the moment you diagnose rightly, the disease will disappear. It is one of the technology from Ayurveda. Same way, the moment your analysis is perfect, the problem will disappear. So, how to know whether your diagnosis is perfect? Your analysis is perfect. The more and more problem melting down will be the signal through which you can know more and more your analysis is right.
So how to sharpen and strengthen my will and determination so
completion.
Completion. How to go about, that's why.
Yesterday I was giving you the process. Every night at least sit 21 minutes. To relive all the suppressed suffocation, powerlessness of your life. Just 21 minutes, allow that suffocation consciously to come upon you. Relive. Reliving is the most powerful way of relieving. Completion can bring completely new energy into your neurology, into your whole system. Completion can bring completely new energy in your very frequency, in your very aura. So solution for the problem you are asking is every day completion. spend at least 21 minutes before going to bed. You can sit in the bed and allow everything to come up and relive. The reliving relieves you.
I need to be guided in that direction.
Blessings. Tathas.
Thank you.
Yanatma.
The next question is from Edgewater, New Jersey. Irina is asking, dear Swamiji, could you please talk on how to love yourself? I find it difficult.
Irina, first thing I want to tell you, deep incompletions about you makes you forget the great things you experienced or achieved. Actually, for next few minutes, I want you to do this exercise. Even in this yesterday and today, yesterday 3 hours and today last 1 hour, what all deep clicks happened, liberating cognitions happened, understanding happened in you. If you remember and pen them down at least once and see, only then you will understand. Otherwise, you will just take this whole thing for granted. You will forget. In your life, you constantly take good things for granted. Remember only pain, suffering, suffocation, even though you don't want to remember them. Incompletions with yourself, for example, incompletions with your body, the way you look, the way you feel about you, incompletions with your mind, incompletions with your emotions, incompletions with your inability to handle your emotions, and above all, anger towards others, you call it as an incompletion within you. Because when you know you can't express that anger, it will be costly. You just dump it on yourself and suffer with that anger within you. Spend little time completing with you. All the incompletions you have with you, please pen them down. List it. And complete with all of that one by one, one by one, one by one. Actually, some of our devotees there in the center, you can talk to them and they will give you the detailed instruction about completion. Practice it. You will be liberated. I bless you. You will achieve Swapriya, the love for yourself. Maybe I really want to take a few minutes. Please, all of you, take few minutes and pen down yesterday and today what all clarity, understanding happened in you. So at least you will know and you will remember the clicks and understandings you had yesterday and today. Please pen down. Few minutes.
Oh,
కంటిన్యూయింగ్ అనుకొస్తున్న డాన్సర్ ఆఫ్టర్ దిస్ ఫ్యూ మినిట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్సర్సైజ్.
Oh.
Yes. How many of you finished writing? Great. I'll move to further questions.
The next question we have is from Rastatt Center in Germany. Rusbi is asking the question. Rusbi, can you please wave your hand?
Yes.
Rusbi is asking, dear Swamiji, how can I achieve enlightenment in this life?
Rusbi, first please understand, it is a straightforward, simple science. Learn how to complete within you with yourself, how to complete with others who are involved in your life, and how to complete with the cosmos. That's all. Completion with yourself, others, and the whole. It's a very simple, straightforward, direct science. I can give you two options. One, become a subscriber in our Nityananda TV YouTube channel. It's free, available wherever you are. I'll be teaching you to get enlightened in your bedroom. There's a set of clear satsangs, very scientifically described. That is option one. Do it for yourself. If you want me to do it for you, come to IA. Come to Inner Awakening. Understand? These two options are in front of you. Subscribe to the YouTube channel, Nityananda TV. And there is a clear set. Number one, number two, number three, next. Like a completion with yourself, then completion with others, then completion with the cosmos, then manifesting your reality, manifesting others' reality. Step by step, you can do it for yourself. It's completely free. We believe in Vedic tradition, knowledge is free. So I opened it. Please understand, everything I teach in the Inner Awakening is available in the YouTube. You can do it for yourself. That's one option. The second option, if you feel, no, I may not be do it all by myself, I may want you to do it for me. Come to the Inner Awakening. I'll do it for you. Understand? Between these two, take up one. My blessings, you will achieve the enlightenment. Next.
The next question is from Sanase Adinam. Is asking, dear Swamiji, what to do when the self feels it does not deserve to receive life or to live life in a full way?
This thing you need to understand, this is a very cunning way you try to get attention from life. You think by putting yourself in sympathy, self-sympathy, showing yourself as a weak, life is going to immediately rush and attend to you. Because from the young age, we are habituated. If you fall sick, your mom will attend to you. You will have your attention. This is extension of that same pattern. If you are so clear that life does not result, then why don't you commit suicide? Simply, we are trying to make life to run towards us by putting ourselves in the place of victim, the victimhood. Please understand, immediately you need to complete with this pattern, and otherwise you will be naturally suffering and suffocating yourself And anybody who decides to suffer and suffocate themselves, life blesses. So be it, tatastu. Life does not interfere in your desire to suffer. So, this pattern need to be attended. Emergently, it needs to be immediately addressed. It is worst cancerous pattern. So please complete it and drop it. That's the only way life can flow through you.
The next question we have is from Chicago Center. The question is from Reddy is asking a kind of a common question, which many other participants have also submitted. How do I deal with people who are still in blaming game while I am working on a solution to approach to the current conflict?
Understand, even if you classify them as a people who are blaming, that again puts you in the position where you are doing the blame game. Look into it. Yes, there are people who do the blame game, but am I going to approach them far Z or far Y? Approach even them far Z. They will become part of your solution. The moment you classify them as people who do blame game, now you already done the blame game. You put them in X. So look at the whole thing. Yes, people do blame game. Why? Because they do not understand this XYZ theory. Educate them this XYZ theory. When you tell them, look at the Y for Z, not for X, even they will become your partners. And they will also start solving the issues. Nobody is ultimately interested in destroying their life, crying about somebody. People are finally interested about the remaining future. See, it is the remaining future gives you the hope to live. So, really, the remaining future is the hope for everyone to live. Just educate them about this XYZ. Always ask Y for Z, not for X. See, you will always have excess memory about X, good or bad. The excess memory about X is incompletion. Whether rightly or wrongly, the excess influence of the X on you is incompletion. Approach the Y for Z. That's the only way you'll be free from X. Next question.
The next question we will take from Bengaluru Adinam. Please go ahead.
Go ahead.
Swamiji, I'm Vinod coming from Bangalore. My question is related to will. You said will make your problem solves. Will help you to get your problem solved. My question is, will means thought process and approach to solve a problem.
No. Your definition is wrong.
Okay.
All the three statements you made is wrong.
That's right.
I am telling will solve your problem is wrong.
No, I am saying.
I told you will make your problems irrelevant, not just solving. Your problems are not even worthy of being solved.
So you are saying
actually the will just raise your frequency to level where your problems will become irrelevant. You see, your table is filled with all the garbage. You don't know how to solve all these files, complications, and you don't know what to do. If you are trying to solve one by one, file by file, that is solving. Suddenly you get promotion and you are moved to a different job. All these files become redundant and irrelevant to you.
Correct.
There is a big difference between these two. I am telling you, will makes your problems irrelevant to you because it raises your frequency. That's one. The second, the statement you are making, will is to execute. No. As I told you, execution have a lot of load and incompletion in you. I am not asking you to think about it. Will, then you will see so much of energy in you will be available to you. So the execution will not be as you think of execution now. See, now presently how you think of execution. If I say, will make you execute what you want, you will say, already I know how much of suffering is there in the execution. If I have to execute, I don't want this methodology, technology, will and all that. Let me be as I am. Understand?
Yes. Yes.
Because you have so much incompletion about the execution.
Correct, sir.
So don't bother about that now. It is like a doctor is trying to tell the born blind man, hey, I'll do a surgery, you will get your eyes back, you can walk without a stick. The blind man says, doctor, I understand you will do a surgery, I'll get my eyes back, but even then, how can I walk without my stick? He cannot be logically convinced. Once you get your eyes, you don't need stick. He feels, no, I'll get my eyes back, but how will I walk without stick? Because throughout his life he walked with a stick. He thinks it is part of his walking mechanism. So now, logically you can never understand how the will alone can make so much difference. But I tell you, when the will is awakened, you can walk without the stick. The stick is execution. Will is your eye. When your eye is awakened, actually the execution will not be as you think now. It will be totally different. The quality of the execution itself will be different. So I don't want you to use this word for that.
Yes, thank you.
Go ahead.
Swami, yesterday in yesterday's session, one of the things that I realized was that a lot of the projects that I'm working on right now were things that I started because there was just a lot of pain in me that I didn't want to deal with. So to get rid of that, I started this. But I actually like working on the projects. Are they like, should I stop working on these?
No. You should not stop working. You should complete the pains from which you are trying to run away. If you complete the pains, these projects will be more successful than what you think. See, if you do it with your, if you do a project by putting your time, it will only be like a mathematics. If you do it by putting your energy along with time, it means you need to have energy. Now all your energy is caught in the incompletions and pains. Complete and put your energy into it. Then you will see it will come out as art piece. If you put your life, it will come as your own extension. Please understand, whether your job, relationship, career, anything, if you are giving only your time, you are a worker. I do not have in one inch of respect for anybody who is working for somebody. Please understand, I am making a very blank, straightforward statement. Be your boss. Even if you think, no, I am working already for 25 years, how can I give up my job? Take this as a 2-year project. Within 2 years, you will do the transition and become your boss. be your boss. I tell you, after you leave the body, you will understand how much consciously you have grown by being your boss. Please understand, only to the people whom you are serving, your clients, your customers, whom you are enriching, should be your boss. Be your boss. I tell you, consciously you will be complete about life. If you are working for somebody, you will learn only one thing: to give your time. You will never learn the taste and joy of what it is to give your energy along with your time. You will give your energy along with your time only if you are going to be the ultimate beneficiary. If you are going to be the ultimate beneficiary, only then you will put your energy into your time. Otherwise, that's that 9 to 5, especially these government jobs in India. I don't want to talk about it, but you read from my face. No, really. If you want to make some fellow dead, if you want to destroy somebody, if you don't like somebody in your life, want to destroy them, somebody for any reason, just get him a government job in India. For his life is done. No, he learns there the ultimate cunning, cheating methodology of giving only time, even by mistake, not giving little energy or giving little life to his time. So that is the way he will destroy himself. That is the worst, long, prolonged, painful suicide. Giving your time for something, but not giving your energy or life to it, is the most prolonged, most painful suicide possible. Be your boss. You will learn, you will be inspired to give your energy to your time, anything you do. Then you will learn how to give your life to what you are doing, to your time and energy. Understand? The senior devotees and disciples, they know day in and day out. This Rajya Sabha is a witness, this land is a witness. 2001, I started my public life. Now it is 2016. Day in and day out, 20 hours a day, I am doing the same job. Never I felt tired or bored even once. What am I doing? Because I have put my energy and my life into what I am doing. I don't know how many thousands of times I explain unclutching and completion. You will not, if you see the recording of me talking about unclutching and completion in 2002 and 2016, you will not find a single word missing. It will only be getting added. Understand, if you are in a mechanism where you put your energy and life into your time, you will be fulfilled in your life. Do not be in a mechanism where you are constantly taught. Actually, in the government job, your seniors teach you how to cheat. And even if you are putting your energy into it, your life into it, your seniors feel threatened. No, really. See, even in the private sector, if you are putting your energy into your work to the level your seniors can handle you, they are okay. But if you are putting your life into your work where they feel threatened, it is not okay. That is why I am telling you, take up this as a 2-year project in your life. If you are working for somebody, decide in next 2 years I'll become my boss, and it'll really make you put your energy and your life into what you are doing. Not only you will have success, you will have completion, you will have fulfillment. I tell you, deep self-doubt only makes you work for others. Either you spend your life to fulfill your dreams, or somebody will hire you to fulfill theirs. And when you are fulfilling somebody else's dream, you will become naturally cunning to separate your energy and your time. That is why the 9 to 5 is only time for you, not life. How many of you feel the 9 to 5 is only time for you, not life? That's all you know now. No, that is the worst crime you are doing against yourself. Do not separate. Do not be in the structure. Do not be in a mechanism where your life and energy is separated from your time. People come and tell me, time is money, Swamiji. Fool, time is life. What are you talking? The lie you have been taught by the bosses is time is money. No, time is life. Don't be under anybody. I tell you, first few months it may be a struggle. That is why I am saying take 2 years as a transition period. Means do some startup and stabilize it, and put, you see, when something is yours, you will put actually your time, energy, life into it. Then slowly you will get the confidence. The self-doubt will melt down. Yes, I can sit on this throne because the throne is built by me. It's mine. I can sit on it. Your energy, life and time will become one in that. Then naturally you can move from working from somebody to being for yourself. I tell you, in the modern day, working for somebody is the worst crime you will do to yourself. Do not do that crime. Do not abuse yourself by working for somebody. Take this as a project and make it maybe in 1 year or 2 years. You will feel blessed that you lived your life. And I tell you, in the modern day, there are millions, billions of opportunities. Do what you like. Complete and free all your energies from your incompletion, and put your energy into your time. Naturally, your life will flow towards it. You will be successful. You will be celebrating what you are doing. What you are doing will celebrate you. You just celebrating your art is success. If your art celebrates you, that is completion. Understand? Micromanaging your inner space is enlightenment. Micromanaging your outer space is success. Both will happen to you if you are in a mechanism where your time and energy is not separated. I tell you, even the people who hire you, if you put too much of energy and life into what you are doing, which they are not able to comprehend, they will feel threatened. Your great work, your boss will feel threatened. Because that is the whole setup of hiring and firing mechanism. Hiring and firing mechanism. I tell you, take up this one truth in your life. I am 100% guarantee, 100% sure, you will only appreciate me for giving you this advice. Never you will blame me. I have seen this in thousands and thousands of lives. When people merge their energy, life into their time. See, when you are doing something on your own, when you are your boss, you are forced by yourself to merge your energy, life and time. But when you are working for somebody, you are not forced. And you cunningly develop such a logical reasons to convince your boss. You know how to manage him. And people do PhD, how to draw salary without working. I have seen how to manage your job, continue to get bonus salary and never doing any work. In that way, you are not just cheating your boss, your life becomes peace. The energy is separated from time, energy is separated from life, then you feel your life is just poor are those who feel 9 to 5 is only their time, not life. I will not classify poverty based on the zeros they have in their bank. Poor are those who feel 9 to 5 is their time, not life. 24 hours should be your life. It should not be separated as time plus energy, time plus life plus energy. So how many of you understand what I am sharing now? So how many of you feel really you are going to take this up very seriously for next 2 years project? In next 2 years, I'll be my boss. Whoever feels, raise your hand. Come on. My blessings. You will all be successful. You will all be successful. Blessings.
The next question we have is from Melbourne Adinam. Pranam Swamiji, thank you for answering my question. I found you by accident on social media during my seeking stage last year. I feel so drawn to your divine face and feel this is your calling. Is it possible that my intention to visit your ashram and attend the upcoming inner awakening become real even though I have many obstacles?
The first thing, understand, you seeing me is never accident. Please understand, if you seeing me is an accident, you will not continue to see me. If you are continuing to see me, understand, it is not accident. It is not accident. So, the moment you are continuing to see me, it's a calling. Understand that. Second, just create your intention and will to be in the inner awakening. It's my responsibility to clear all the obstacles and make it as reality to you. Whatever may be the obstacle, time, money, anything, I tell you, cosmos only tests your intention, depth of intention, never denies anything for your spiritual growth. Please understand, cosmos may test strength of your intention. It will never deny anything you require for your growth. You require for your spiritual growth or enlightenment. It's a cosmic law. And I am bound to execute that law. Understand? It's a cosmic law. And it's my responsibility to execute the cosmic constitution and law. So don't worry. It will only test your strength of your intention. It will never deny. It will never deprive anything you need to make your spiritual growth, spiritual explosion, spiritual possibility into reality. Just make a will. Intention. It's my responsibility making it into reality. You will attract wealth. You will attract time. You will attract everything. It is not just for her. It's for everyone here. I can actually ask, how many of you experienced this in your life? The moment you made an intention or will for IA, simply it happened. Raise your hand. All these witnesses, just look around the hands in your hall or look around in your screen. Mohini, just look around. How many hands are up? Just see around. The hands up. They are all witnesses. Understand? Next time when I ask, your hands will be up. I tell you. Welcome to the world of miracles. I think it is time. Thank you. Be blissful.